What's up everybody, I'm SystemCheck66 and I thought I'd show you guys my Resident Evil collection, my full collection. Bear with the background sound, you know, my family can be a bit crazy sometimes, so you know, if you hear any shouting or anything else going on, it's them acting like a bunch of donkeys. Alright, so let's get straight into it. First off, the books, yes, they're very tattered, very used, but I love reading them, so you know, these are the only books that I'll sit down and read all the way through, to be honest. I'm not a big book reader. Gotta be honest. Umbrella Conspiracy, best one of the lot. I advise you try and get these. They've been reprinted, so you know, I have an actual reprint of Zero Hour. Sorry about my finger, by the way, cut myself. So yeah, like Caribbean Cove, standalone story. SD Perry did a good job with that. Obviously City of the Dead based on 2. Underworld, another standalone story, quite good. Code Veronica. Nemesis, yep, and Zero Hour, based on Resident Evil Zero. So, they're all the books, got them all. Then we got the comics. I've got issues 1 to 5, I'm missing issue 2. Oh shit, pick that back up. Yeah, I'm missing issue 2, which is based on the second game. But yeah, I've got issues 1 to 5. 5's a bit tatty. Unfortunately, it ripped when I was, you know, reading it and whatnot. I'm trying to sell some of those, and I'm trying to sell issue 1, but this doesn't go for less than 250 quid. To be honest, it's hard to get in the UK, and yeah, I'm not parting with it for any less. Okay, let's move on. Let's move on to the films. Move these out quickly. Yeah, so I got Degeneration. Kicked it off, the CGI sort of trilogy. I've got the first live action film. It's a 6 out of 10 film. It's still fairly enjoyable, but you know, it doesn't live up to the source material, let's just say that. And it was disappointing when I watched it in the cinema. I've since kind of, you know, grown a little bit of a love for it as a guilty pleasure. But the sequels I had to get rid of, had to sell them. I don't even know why the fuck I bought them, to be honest. But yeah, it's enjoyable at least, but it doesn't live up to the game standard. We've got Vendetta. Fun, but really over the top and silly, a bit like Resident Evil 6. And my favourite of the trilogy, Damnation. Yeah, I like that film. It's really good. Okay, let's go on to the PS4 Resident Evil games. We've got the best version of Resident Evil 4, in my opinion. We've got the remake of 2, which is a very good game, very good remake. Not as good as the original, doesn't live up to the original or the remake of the first one, but it's good. We've got the Origins Collection. Definitive collection of these games, must own. That's Resident Evil Remake and Zero, by the way. This is basically Resident Evil Gold Edition, but on PS4, picked up for like 12 quid. It's cheap, so you know, I can play it with my mate as well, co-op. Resident Evil 7, which brought the series back to survival horror, and I like it. Next we got the PS3 Resident Evils. I picked this up for £3, so you know, why not? It's cheap as piss. Resident Evil Revelations 1. I don't really like Revelations 2, but the first one is actually quite good. Now, I only played this later on when I had a 360. I didn't play it, you know, on a 3DS, and I didn't, you know, have a PS3 at the time, but I rebought it because I really like it. So, it's a good game. GameCube. Resident Evil Remake. Amazing game. My second favourite Resident Evil game to date, next to the original Resident Evil 2. And I got this for £6. So, I was chuffed. Deals. Absolute deals. Resident Evil Zero, I got this for about £5. Yeah, at the same time I got the first one, so wicked. I've got the Resident Evil Archives version of Resident Evil Remake on the Wii. If you have a GameCube controller, you're sorted, like I, you know, like me, I do, so I can play it easily. But if you're playing it with the Wii controller, you're gonna have some problems. It doesn't play well with that. So I advise you spend some money on a GameCube controller or a WaveBird, and that's the best way to play this. Now, this is something of a hard to find item, and one of my prized Resident Evil sort of, you know, items in my collection. It only came out in stores in the UK, I believe. Maybe it did come out in America as well. Electronic Boutique, it's hard to see that. My phone's not like capturing it well, but yeah, if you can see by the side, it says Game. So Electronic Boutique was owned by Game, and now Game's just called Game. So back in the day, this was given to you if you pre-ordered Code Veronica X. So yeah, it's really cool. It's basically a physical version of Wesker's report with the voice actor who voiced him during Code Veronica's, you know, sort of time, and I think the Resident Evil remake and Zero. So yeah, it's really, really cool. I forget his name, but he's my favorite Wesker voice actor. Then we've got the PS2 Resident Evil's Outbreak. Didn't like this when it first came out. Then when I got it later on, found a love for it. Absolutely love it. I'm trying to get Outbreak File 2. But at the moment, I've got tons of games to play, so that's something for a later date. But yeah, really like Outbreak, the first one. Definitely get that if you haven't played it. Code Veronica X, I did have the original version that came with the Devil May Cry demo and stuff. And obviously, you know, I sold a lot of my games back in the day, my consoles, things like that. Just, I was more about current gen and things, but now, you know, I've become a collector. But yeah, I picked it up again. It's a Platinum Edition, you know, whatever. It's cool, at least I have the game, so. And last but no means least, the classics. Bit of a weird way how I turn that around, but anyway. I've got Resident Evil Director's Cut. This is the very first game I ever played. It's what kicked it off for me. It's an amazing game. I love it. The remake is better. It's vastly better. But yeah, it's still great. I love this game. And I paid about 40 quid for this. And it comes with Resident Evil 2 like demo. So I was very, very happy with that. This is identical to the, you know, the copy that I owned back in the day. So this is the first game I ever played in the Resident Evil series. I've been there from day one, man. My favorite game of all time. I do own two copies of this. I'll explain why in a minute. But I got this version, which was slightly expensive. Not good English. It was a bit more expensive than the other version I picked up because I wanted the OG version, man. I'm a huge, this is my favorite game of all time. So, you know, it's probably one of the only games I'll ever do it with. But yeah, it has the printed discs. That's why I wanted it. So I picked it up. What more can be said? This is the game that I always go back to. This is a game that for me is like Pac-Man to other people, or trying to think now, Mario Brothers. This is my Pac-Man, my Mario Brothers, my Pong. Like, this is the best game ever made, in my opinion. Fight me. And I have the Platinum version. I picked this up for about, I think it was about 15 quid, so it was cheaper. And I just wanted to grab the game, you know, rebuy it. And so I picked this up. And then that's when, after that, I got the other version. But yeah, man. Still, cool. Glad to have two copies of it. And last but no means least, Resident Evil Nemesis. The original. We're talking about the original. This game is iconic. It is a fucking classic. And I've played this nearly as much as I played Director's Cut, the remake of the first game, and also Resident Evil 2. Probably nearly the same amount as Resident Evil 2. I love this game. I love it to death. And it's a classic. It's a PlayStation classic. It is an era classic. It is fucking amazing. And I'm glad that I've got every version of the games from Director's Cut to Nemesis with the printed discs, you know, and they're the official versions, not the Platinum ones, you know, so, or the original versions, not the Platinum ones. So I'm really happy to have all the games, you know, as they were back in the day when I owned them. Yeah, I was an idiot to get rid of my PlayStation and my games and everything else, you know, my Dreamcast and all that stuff. I was, but when you're younger, you know what I mean? You don't really think about that sort of stuff. It's as you get older, you want to start collecting. So to get the original trilogy again has been my goal. And that's my main goal, really, as an OG Resident Evil fan, as someone that loves the series so much. My main goal has always been to get the games again. And I've succeeded in that. And then I've just sort of built on top of my collection with, you know, with other games, which are all the way over there. That's just some of them. But yeah. I've got loads of survival horror in that pile, in those piles as well. But yeah, love this game. And, you know, all right, the remake might have changed some things that I'm not happy about. But there are things in that game that look incredible. I thought the demo was a lot of fun to play. I like the Nemesis. I like Jill's new redesign. There's a lot of stuff that's good about it. You know, it's not all negatives. That's what I'm saying. I just had to balance it out with some things that I didn't like and some things that I do like. But look, I don't know if it's going to beat the OG Nemesis, man. Like, the remake of 2 didn't beat the original Resident Evil 2, in my personal opinion. And I don't think it's going to beat, you know, the remake of 3 is going to beat the original Nemesis. But I'm sure it'll be a good game. I am. So anyway, that's my collection. I hope you enjoyed it. Finally, I've dug through my crate of games. I've had to take games off of games, dig to the bottom, you know, pull out these games and stuff just to show you guys my collection, because I wanted to show you guys my collection. Because you know what? I could have been talking absolute shit and you guys think, well, he could just be talking shit. He's not a real Resident Evil fan, you know what I mean? So, you know, it's early. I want to get back to Doom Eternal. One love to you know, to all my people on my YouTube channel. Thanks for the subscribers. Thanks for the love you've been showing. All you guys that are showing the love. And yeah, I'll catch you again next time. I've been SystemCheck66. Signing out of here. Stars. Hey everyone, if you made it to the end of the video, I hope you enjoyed looking at my collection. Sorry for my voice. It's a little bit nasally at the moment. I have a cold. I don't have the C virus. If you know where I'm coming from, I can't actually say the name of it on here. I'll get sort of like blacklisted by YouTube. But yeah, that's why I sound a bit nasally. Other than that, I forgot to show you guys my Resident Evil manga, the Mahawaya Desire. I have the first issue, the original print. And it's just because, one, I forgot about it. Two, I don't own any other issues. And three, I'm not really a huge fan of it. I've got to be honest. I think it's maybe because it links to Resident Evil 6. That's why I'm not a big fan. You know, and it carries on after Resident Evil 5. And that's why I forgot to add it into the video. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, smash the like button. Subscribe to the channel if you like me as a Resident Evil content creator. And until next time, I've been SystemCheck66. And I'm signing out. Peace. Have a good day.